All right, we say good morning to our friend Mike Eppel, standing by on an already Wednesday morning, Mike. Already hump day. Good morning to you.
Where's the week going?
It's like that.
I thought about that when I woke up this morning. What day is this?
And you were pleasantly surprised, right?
Yeah, I
felt good about it.
Okay.
Fine. Okay. Come on, Mike. We're always looking for the positive here with you. let's get. You know, my goal for the morning is always to make you laugh, make you smile, or something.
Yes.
Just shake it
Thank
up a
you.
Bit.
I appreciate that.
There you have it. Okay.
You've been successful so far.
Yes, that's the goal, Mike. let's take a look at the markets now. So far, how are we doing?
Well, yesterday and the day before that, and the day before that, from a financial standpoint, weren't very good, Melanie. In fact, over a three-day time frame, we've seen the NASDAQ on Wall Street drop over 10%. The Dow's been down 5.5% over 3 days. You know, we were talking over the later stages of the summer days leading up to Labor Day about how stocks had hit records, and Tesla, for example, was this massive automaker that was just, you know, going stratospheric for its share price. Apple was over $2 trillion in market value. Well, yesterday, Tesla dropped 21%, largest single-day sell-off for the stock in its history. It's lost about $100 billion in market value, which, if you tabulate the combined worth of General Motors and Ford, that single day or multiple day decline for Tesla is worth more than Ford and GM, traditional automakers. I mean, it's been a dramatic downturn here. It's still worth $300 billion. I don't want to get too far into the weeds here with some of these gigantic numbers that Tesla has accumulated. But what we've seen, Melanie, is the fact that, you know, there's been day trading on the stock, options, all sorts of computer algorithms that have driven it to record highs. And a lot of the tech companies had been caught up in that frothy nature of the markets. Other factors at play, though, Tesla has a new competitor coming on in the pickup truck market. You know, last year we were talking about the Cybertruck for Tesla. Well, another company called Nikola, Nikola Tesla, from the invention of, what was it, alternator current? I can't remember. Anyway, so Nikola Corp signed on with General Motors to develop a pickup truck called the Badger.
Let's see it.
It's more traditional looking, I suppose, in the Cybertruck of Tesla. It's going to be interesting to see when these specifically come to market, what the take-up rate is for an electric, all-electric pickup.
Okay, I don't know if we have that picture. Maybe we don't have that picture for you. I know you sent it to us. That's interesting. We'll tweet that one out and see what it looks like. Porter Airlines, so we know pushing back the dates here.
Yeah, into November. And this is the third time that Porter has said, can't fly yet. You know, the travel restrictions are still in place, certainly on cross-border travel. And I think the bigger issue for Porter is they fly small aircraft. You know, they don't have the ability to actually have physical distancing on the planes themselves. They're flying Dash 8s, right? So it's just a system. Because we can, you know, fly to points across the country, there's no specific restrictions on that, but in Porter's case, the planes are so small that they just might not be able to offer up the physical distancing requirements that the passengers right now are looking for. So those planes remain grounded at the Island Airport.
Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, I want to show you the picture. We do have that, our control room flagging the Badger. Okay. We want to show you that pickup truck. There it is.
Yeah, see, that looks much more traditional. Remember that Cybertruck from Tesla looked really futuristic?
It did.
Sort of Total Recall-ish.
Yes.
Well, this might be a seller. Of course, price point, you know, range, all these kind of things. They say it could have up to 900 horsepower because you need that if you want to pull a house off of its foundations.
Because who needs that? Yeah, exactly. finally, Lululemon, no surprise here. Their numbers looking good.
Pardon me?
Their numbers looking good. Phenomenal, I should say.
Yes, very much. Very much because people working from home, they want comfortable clothing. They're willing to pay a premium price for Lululemon items. E-commerce sales up 155%. And, you know, that in and of itself is the reality of the summer marketplace for retail. E-commerce was all the rage.
Mm-hmm.
Will it last? Will it continue that trend into the holidays? Lululemon's being kind of cautious about that, actually, saying they have to spend more to market more against competitors such as Nike and others in that comfy clothing, sports, attire, yoga marketplace.
It is so cozy, but you know, so long as that we're doing those virtual meetings and then bottoms down, you can wear those yoga pants, they're gonna keep on selling.
Theoretically.
I love them. I love them. I'm not gonna lie, Mike. Do you wear yoga pants waist down?
No,
you don't have to show us.
Actually, do not.
Leave it there.
Not saying I'm not
Mystery.
Wearing pants,
Okay, no, listen, I didn't put words in your mouth. You do not. There you go. Thanks, Mike.
Khakis all the way.
Have a good day. Khakis.